CSS and the JavaScript files, as well as the jQuery and jQuery UI. So I'm just going to copy this example from here. Copy this and put it in my layout. Use shared layout CSHTML. So jQuery is already referenced, but I'll delete this line because I have it in the code that I've just copied. So, okay. This is the CSS files and the JavaScript files. jQuery, jQuery UI, and awesome. That's it. Save. Now let's try and use the Ajax drop-down helper. First, we're gonna need to add the controller, home controller, call it home. So add the view, and the index view, eraser, okay. So in order to use an awesome helper, we just type HTML. Oh. And as we can see, it's red. We have to import the using awesome MVC in each page that we use these helpers. This is one way, but another way would be to import it for all pages at once. For this we have to edit the for razor views, we have to edit the web config inside the views folder, just like here. Was it for, you can see here for razor views in the views web config and for web form views in the main web config. So let's copy this and put it in here. Save it. Now it works. We don't need to add the using in each page. Ajax drop-down. And for the name, let's call it fruit. Let's see how it works straight away. So we have an Ajax drop-down. Now if we open the Mozilla Firebug plugin and refresh the page, we are going to see an Ajax request that was sent by the Ajax drop-down. It was sent to the fruit Ajax drop-down get items, and this controller at the moment doesn't exist, so we get this error that it wasn't found. By default, the Ajax drop-down, it looks for a controller with the same name as him, fruit, plus its type, Ajax drop-down. So let's create it. And just for the start, I'm just going to copy it from here, from the wrong page, and replace some stuff. Fruit. Ajax drop-down get items. This is the select V, is the selected value, the current value of the drop-down. You can see it here in the post. This is the parameter that was sent. It has no value at the moment, so nothing was sent. Okay. V, and we must return a list of selectable items, which is from AMO awesome MVC. Okay, we added this. And we'll do something very simple, just a simple list of selectable item. Just like that. JSON of selectable item. So, yeah. Value 1 for text, we're gonna write mango, banana, apple, 2, 3. Okay, build, and let's refresh the page, and that's it. We have the values, they are here. You can see the Ajax request, we have the response as JSON. Now that we have this drop-down working, we can use it multiple times anywhere in our project just by declaring it. surface on our view model, view 1, 2, and 3, and also I'm going to add another Ajax dropdown controller for them. I'm going to call it view param Ajax dropdown controller, and we're gonna have a parameter category. This is about the parameter that is going to be predefined. I'm going to use it here, where category equals category ID. And I'll delete this. Okay. So now let's edit our view. Line break here. I'm just going to copy this. Okay, meal warm. I'll have to indicate the controller. Meal arm Ajax dropdown controller. And our parameter. A parameter named category. So basically we're saying that for categories, set the value 1. That's it. Mil 2 and 3. Category will be 2 and 3. So basically the category parameter will get the value 1, 2 and 3 from here. And for each dropdown. So let's build. See how it works. So here's our dropdowns, and the first one shows only the first category, the second category, and the third, as you can see. And you can look here and see that the category parameter was sent with the value 1 here, and the value 2 and 3. Okay, now another thing that is used quite often is when we have the first option as text not selected or something like this, and an very much for watching and goodbye.